Welcome to John Lewis 3D Learning. In this presentation, we are going to see 5th standard, Term 3, Science, Unit 3, Air Chapter, English Medium, Exercise Number 5, that is Detailed Answer, from page number 106. Answer in detail. There are two questions. The first question is, list the importance of air. And second question, explain any three airborne diseases. Now let us see one by one. Let's take the first question. List the importance of air. So there are many uses of air, but we learn at least some five important uses. So it is used in wind energy. First of all, in what category air is used, and then we will see it in detail. Then in sports it is used, and third one, plants are using air, and then it gives life, you know, to all human beings, animals, plants, for everybody. And then five, water cycle. See, we learnt so many times, you know, in science and social science in previous terms, what is water cycle. So without air, that water cycle is not possible. Okay, now let us see one by one. So wind energy. Air is used to produce electrical power. So we have seen in this chapter, you know, windmills are used to produce electrical energy, isn't it? So the windmills are rotated. The fan in the windmills are rotated by what? Air. So without air, the wings of the fan cannot be rotated, and without rotating the wings of the fan, electrical energy cannot be produced. Therefore, air is used in wind energy. Then second one, sports. You take anything, football, volleyball, basketball, the ball is filled with what inside? Air, isn't it? And then the paragliding also. So you might have seen people flying, no? Using some glides. So that is what is called the paragliding. Over the sea, over the mountain, they simply fly. Okay, that is called, that sport is called paragliding. So that also uses the wind. That is nothing but air. Okay, paragliding, football, volleyball, basketball, anything for that matter, everything uses air. And then plants. So plants use nitrogen present in air for its growth. Then it gives life, no? Human beings, no? We breathe air. So we take in oxygen present in air and giving out carbon dioxide, isn't it? Okay, therefore, air, without air, we cannot breathe, we cannot get oxygen. Therefore, it gives life to all human beings, even animals also. All living beings, no? They need air. Okay, last one is water cycle. So we have seen in previous term, what is water cycle? So sea water is converted into water vapor, and then they condense into clouds, no? Water liquids, and then again it is falling back into the sea. So this is what is called the water cycle. So without air, the water cannot be evaporated. No, the water cannot be evaporated, and they cannot form clouds, and they can condense together again to form water droplets and fall like rain, isn't it? So without air, this cycle is not possible. So air is important for the formation of water cycle. Okay, now let us quickly revise this. List the importance of air. First of all, even though there are many application uses of air, let us write only very important five things. So wind energy, sports, plants, gives life, and water cycle. How it is used in wind energy? Air is used to produce electrical power. In sports, paragliding, football, volleyball, basketball, anything for that matter, they all use air. Then plants use nitrogen present in air for its growth. Then gives life. So we breathe air and use the oxygen present in air, without which we cannot live, isn't it? Okay, the last one is water cycle. Air is important for the formation of water cycle. So these are the five important uses of air. So this question may be asked in 5 mark question, so you can write just 5 points, that's more than enough. So let's move on to the next question. Explain any 3 airborne diseases. There are so many diseases, no, which is caused by air. So let us take the three important commonly people get these diseases. So tuberculosis, that is shortly known as TB. The other one is called influenza, shortly known as flu. And third one, whooping cough. Continuously people will be coughing. So that is what is called woofing cough, non-stop cough. Okay, now let us see one by one. So we go back and see one by one. So what is the first one? Tuberculosis. So that is shortly known as what? TB. So what are the three airborne diseases first of all? Tuberculosis. What is the second thing we have taken? Influenza. And what is the third thing? Woofing cough. These are the three main diseases caused by air. Okay, first let us take tuberculosis. TB is caused by bacteria present in air. So TB is caused by bacteria. What is the name of that bacteria? Mycobacterium tuberculosis. See, bacteria, tuberculosis, that is same from the name. Myco, that is what you need to remember. Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So TB is caused by the bacteria present in air. That bacteria is called Mycobacterium tuberculosis. When we breathe air, this bacteria present in air enters into our lungs and affect it. So this is a bacteria, that is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. When we breathe air, when it is present in air, that also goes inside along with the air and affects our lungs. Then second one is influenza, that is called flu. So it is also known as flu. It is caused by the virus. It is not caused by bacteria. It is caused by virus. What is the name of that virus? Myxovirus. Myxovirus. Okay. Then it results in inflammation. Inflammation means what? Swelling. It results in the inflammation of nasal, mucosa and pharynx. It results in the inflammation of nasal, mucosa and pharynx. Okay, the third one, explain the three airborne diseases. The third point is what? Woofing cough. Continuously coughing. You might have seen old people, no? Some people will be coughing continuously. It affects the respiratory tract, causes mild fever and severe cough. So when we breathe, the air goes inside, no? That pathway is affected. It affects the respiratory tract, the pathways of air going inside and coming out. So that pathway is affected, causing mild fever and severe cough. It is caused by the bacteria Bordetella pertussis. Bordetella pertussis. So this is the name of the bacteria. So these are the three main airborne diseases. What are they? What is the first one we had seen? Tuberculosis. What is the second one? Influenza. What is the third one? Woofing cough. Hope you understood these three airborne diseases, how it is caused, what is the name of the bacteria or virus causing that particular airborne disease and what it affects. So these are the main thing we need to write here. Hope you enjoyed learning from me and you liked learning this way. If you like it, please share it with your fellow teachers and your students' parents. Thank you very much for watching. Until we meet next time. Bye-bye.